Okay, guys, this is the motivational intervention model as I suggested just now. So there are 6 steps, and one of the steps are assessment of current eating behavior. If you look back at the notes that I've given you in early, in the beginning, I said that there's a one whole note that you can read. So if you go through one by one, there's the specific details of each steps, okay? Try to look and read, not just look, but read, okay? So number 5, there's assessment of current eating behavior. So how do you assess the current eating behavior, guys? Yes, if you read, you'll know. But never mind, I will just give you the answer, which is through the adherence ruler. Alright? So read through the notes. What does it mean by the adherence ruler? Okay? Pembaris. Ruler to pembaris, okay? And then number 6 is the assessment of readiness to change. So we want to assess our client in which stage does the client is ready to change. Okay? So first of all, there's three steps for assessment assessment of readiness to change, which is number 1, the client is not ready to change counseling session. So when the client is not ready to change, these are the steps that you need to do. So you have to give open-ended questions. Okay, what does even mean open-ended question? It's like the open-ended questions exam. So you have you can open the book. Okay, so it has no ended question. It's not like you give a question and there's A, B, C, D. That is we call closed-ended question. So open-ended, there's no answer for the question. Reflective listening. If you notice there's when I shadow the words, it means that it is important for you to look at the notes. What does it mean by reflective listening? And then affirming, summarizing, eliciting self-motivating statements, and ending the session. Alright? This is the step for not ready to change. Alright? So the second step is when the client is unsure about the changes. So our goal is to build readiness to change, discuss client's perception of barriers, discuss thoughts and feelings, and then we try to negotiate the set goals, consider options, arrange for the next contact. Okay? And the last one is the client is ready to change. So the steps for our counseling is that you have to collaborate with the client to set goals for change that include a plan of action. Nutrition counselor provide tools, action plan, arrange for next contact. So basically it's all happen to sound like same, but easy to set again, but difficult to implement. Alright, so when you are in the real situation with a client, it's going to be a bit challenging, alright? Because manusia semua warna rambut hitam, tapi hati lain-lain, kan? Okay, tak semua rambut hitam yang color tu lain lah ceritanya, kan? Okay. So these are the resistant behaviors. Okay, so bila ada rintangan terhadap sesuatu tingkah laku tersebut, what we need to do, we reflect back. We give double-sided reflection, shift focus, agree with a twist. Kita setuju tapi kita buat twist pula, twist plot. Emphasize personal choice, reframe. So, again, all this ada dalam nota yang saya bagi. So, try to read and focus properly on those shadow words that I've shadowed. Okay? Okay, I think that's all for the important part. So this topic is just simple and short, okay? So this is more on the documentation that you need to have during the counseling, so no important things. All right so ini sangat penting sekali, memang kita betul-betul deal dengan klien, terutama kalau bidang dietitian dan sebagainya lah, okay? Sebab kalau kita perasan dekat klinik kesihatan, dia ada pakar dietetik di mana dia perlu berjumpa dengan klien and try to convince them to change. Contohnya pakcik tu suka makan manis, suka minum manis tapi susah nak berubah kepada behavior kurangkan manis dan sebagainya. So how do the dietitian address the pakcik to change the behavior? So all of that ada dalam teori-teori tertentu. So teori-teori ni lebih kepada scientific steps lah, alright? So bukan main suka-suka je nak tukar. So that's why behavior is very hard to change. Okay, bukan senang. It may take months, it may take years. Sebab itulah dalam transurological change tu ada yang makan masa kurang daripada 6 bulan dan sebagainya. Okay, sebab tu kalau you nak cari pasangan, you dah kata, okay, contoh you nak pasangan you tak nak merokok. Tiba-tiba you dapati pasangan you tu merokok and then dia kata, okay lah lepas kahwin dia akan berubah. Jangan percaya. Kalau dia nak betul-betul nak berubah, berubah daripada sekarang. Okay? Tiba-tiba pula kan? So, untuk transtheoretical model, you boleh tengok lagi satu contoh. Saya ada bagi dalam e-learn juga. Okay? You boleh tengok dekat sini. Additional note untuk transtheoretical. Okay? Itu saja guys. Assalamualaikum. Tak jumpa butang tutup pula.